fifth Cornhill Test match at Edgbaston. Welcome to the highlights of the first day. A vital match this for both teams. They stand at 1-1 in the series. 6 Test matches in this series. The one here and then the final one at the Oval. And the teams showed changes from the match at Old Trafford. England have given Les Taylor his first Test match cap. They've brought in Richard Ellison and Jonathan Agnew is 12th man. For Australia, well, they've gone in with 5 bowlers. It's an attacking gesture by Border and his tour selectors. Thompson comes in for Matthews, and Graham Wood, who was injured at Old Trafford, comes in for the top scorer in that match in the first innings, David Boone. Well, conditions very overcast, although there were some patches of sunshine and blue sky. Thought of heavier showers later on in the afternoon. The first surprise came when David Gower won the toss and put Australia in. We pick up play now in the very first over. It's the fourth ball, a single on the board. Botham is the bowler and Andrew Hilditch is taking strike.
Well bowled. That's the sort of movement that England would be looking for after putting Australia in this morning.
Yes, a little bit of swing and movement off the seam. Well directed, perhaps a little bit wide. You see Andrew Hilditch turning round a little bit there, getting a bit square on.
There's nobody down there at third man. Races away for 4. Perfectly executed shot there. Right on top of it, kept it down, and 4 good runs to see Andrew Hilditch away. So from the City End, the first time in a Test match for Les Taylor. And as his name's announced, he gets a nice little round of applause. Field in any sort of position these days is Alan Lamb. Shot down quickly away to his right. And it's the sort of stop that we've been seeing from Alan Lamb all through the summer. Botham to Wood. That's short, hooked away high. Well, I must say, this Graham Wood does take life in his hands.
Yeah, it's not a very good shot, this. So far outside the off stump to fetch that. Very chancy shot. It's, must be so much easier to hit that square on the offside.
He's a regular artist. Been doing the whole of the series. Some quite exquisite work of all these Test match grounds. It's a better looking shot, beautiful stroke this time. That's 4 runs.
That's a lovely shot from Graham Wood.
Botham coming round the wicket to try and counteract it. Looking for 2 here. That's another beautiful stroke for 4 runs. It's the way to play the short one outside the off stump. No need for him to worry about pulling or hooking. Not when he can play the ball like that. It's Taylor now to Wood. Oh, it's another glorious stroke. Over pitch ball, just lent on that, timed it to perfection through the covers for 4. Botham then to Hilditch. Well, the bouncer's gone for four, and that's 1,000 runs. That's the blow that Hilditch wanted, to go on to exactly 1,000 runs in Test cricket. Botham now to Wood.
It looks like it, David Constant, I think, then gave an official warning. He certainly had a word with the other umpire and a word with David Gower about Ian Botham running on the pitch. If that is an official warning, which it looked like, then obviously Ian Botham's under a bit of pressure. He can't afford to do it more than once more.
Does it look very much as though it could have been a warning, because David Constant got the notebook out, started scribbling in it. Oh, well, we got a bowling change. Certainly, I listen to Hilditch. It's a beautiful stroke. Really clipped that half around the leg stump in great style through mid-wicket. So, four more to Hilditch.
Certainly, there's no way Phil Edmonds could get to that, a similar shot to the one before, but this time it just absolutely whistled past him.
Botham now to Wood.
And he's gone. Inside edge, onto hip. And Edmonds, who was feeling back quite a bit further there for Graham Wood, had the chance to go across to his left, dive and pick up a very, very good catch. And a very fine catch here by Phil Edmonds, who is naturally left-handed. It would have been very difficult for a right-handed fielder there, but you can see that being naturally left-handed allowed him to dive behind square from just in front, and a very fine catch indeed. Just a little bit of extra bounce there, because basically this wicket has no bounce at all, but that did just bounce a little bit, and an inside edge probably onto his thigh pad, and it just carried. Good anticipation. And a fine catch. And he clung onto it and very cleverly turned his hand so the back of the hand was hitting the ground and the ball was facing up. 44 for one. Kept the vessels. Brilliant. Phil Edmonds. Phil Edmonds, he really is a good fielder in there. He's only 2 or 3 yards off the bat, and the batsman playing it quite firmly there. You can see out of his ground. And just made it back if he'd have hit the wickets, but pretty quick there. Kept the vessels off the mark. Les Taylor is the fielder. No man down for Kepler Vessels, no man down at third man. And three more to the left-hander. Well, you couldn't place it very much better than that. There were two men there within, 35 yards of one another, way down the boundary. And in addition, David Constant is having another word with Ian Botham. Constant is saying that that footmark is in the danger spot. Botham is saying it's not. And they've agreed to differ. 50 up for Australia. Ian Botham is the wicket taker. He's bowled with plenty of pace this morning. Taylor now has taken off his heavy sweater and is going to bowl in the short sleeve, so it's none too warm here at Edgbaston. There's a third man now, but he's fairly fine. That's Mike Gatting, and can't do anything at all about that.
Very much the old loosener. Wide and very gentle pace outside the off stump, short. And that's nearly kept the vessel's favourite shot.
Difficult chance there, but one that Beltham so often collects. Ball went extremely quickly to nasty height.
Yes, and Kepler Vessels having a real go at that, and it went very, very fast. I think the slips have come up because there hasn't been a great deal of bounce on the ball. But you can see Kepler Vessels slashing at that, and it going very quickly. But both them getting both hands to it.
Let off then for Kepler Vessels on 13. Beautiful stroke. There's a half volley. Each time he's dropped it, there has been put away. Wood doing it earlier, and now a replica of the shot coming from Kepler Vessels. That's another nicely timed shot. Same sort of length, this time around about leg stump. Come back for three quite comfortably.
Fine bit of feeling there by Richard Ellison. Beautiful throw right over the top. It's one thing about this England side, they do feel well in the outfield nowadays. Nice shot here by Wessels, just clipping the ball away off his toes, just behind square. Good timing.
Phil Edmonds taking over from Ellison down at the City End. That's clipped nicely through. There's nobody back on the boundary, and that'll bobble away for four. Taylor to Vessels. It's a half volley again. It's passed with some authority once again by Kepler Vessels. Beautifully placed through the offside. Correctly timed, and it's four more.
Wessels getting a few more runs off the front foot this match. He doesn't get too many through there, but again, he does really keep his head down. You can really see that right over the top of the ball. Look at that, head really down. No chance of that ball going in the air.
Edmonds. Wasn't too far away, but it's going for four all the same. Edmonds' mid-off is quite wide.
Phil Edmonds over-pitching again here, and Ilditch very quick onto the front foot, and a powerful drive through mid-off.
Big shout going up, and up goes the finger, and he's gone. So a wicket for Edmonds, 92 for two. Ilditch goes for 39. And a faint little tickle there down the lakeside. I think we'll see again.
And Ian Botham demonstrating to Phil Edmonds, is strangled one out there. After turning the ball previously, that one went on down the leg side, and probably Ilditch just waiting for it to spin back, which it didn't. And he just got a little tickle to the keeper. And well taken by the keeper. There's been quite a bit of criticism of Downton, but that was a pretty good catch there for the keeper.
Yes, the one that mattered stayed in the gloves. So Australia's hero, Mr. Border. Edmondson over the wicket to Border. And turn again. And that well worth another look.
Perhaps a little touch of luck there for Alan Border, and two more runs added up to the luncheon interval to take the Australians along to a most satisfactory 96 for two. I think they'd have settled for that at the end of the day.
It's a good shot. Now, we've got an idea of how slow the outfield is after that rain. That ball normally would have gone to the boundary, but it's been slowed up enough so that Vessels will take three. 100 comes up for Australia for the loss of two wickets, Wood and Hilditch, two openers. Edmonds to bowl to Border. That couldn't have been very far away.
I think that was probably an eighth of an inch outside the off stump.
David Gower standing at mid-off. Blessing the sunshine, I would think. They want to get as much play in as possible. So, to Australia, but England having put Australia in today. And have been at all pleased about the rain. And Gower confirmed today as captain for the tour of the West Indies later in the year.
That's a good shot. That's going to bring him 50 up. Fine forcing shot of the back foot by a couple of vessels takes him onto the half century. Edmonds again. And asking for it this time, but nobody's offering to go. Neither is the batsman, and he might well be quite right.
Well, I don't think Phil Edmonds has any doubt in his mind there. In fact, he's still shaking hands with Wessels down at this end. Certainly see it thump the pad, whether it got a little touch on the bat. It's always difficult to tell.
Well, I would have thought that was a good decision by the umpire.
Now to Alan Border. Slightly in the air, but punched away beautifully by Alan Border through mid-wicket. A no-ball call by umpire Constant. It's been quite a good spell from Les Taylor since he came back on from Villanend. He's had 16 runs taken from six overs, but he's beaten Alan Border two or three times. Would have missed leg stump. A little bit of bounce as well. 16 overs, two maidens, none for 50 now in all. Richard Ellison now to come in to Kepa Vessels. He bowled just 11 balls to him earlier. Down a difficult chance, but he made ground to it and got his left hand there. Tim Robinson, the fielder.
I think it's a slightly slower delivery, and Wessels just a little bit early on it. Didn't go all that hard, in fact. And I think possibly there, Robinson could maybe have got two hands to it. Certainly a little bit slow in bringing that right hand into action.
There's Taylor to Vessels. That looked as though it might have been a catch. First glance, one might have thought it was a bump ball, but a feeling that it was punched away by Vessels on the half volley, as indeed it was.
and Taylor was just a fraction slow to pick it up. So two chances in two overs for England. And another one early on, all of them Kepler vessels.
Yes, when the captain sends in the opposition, he really does expect every catch to be taken. In fact, they have to be taken if that sort of move is to turn out to be successful. Eight more runs were added up to the close of play at 7 o'clock, 181 for two, and I reckon the Australians will be absolutely delighted with that. They've gone in with five bowlers, they've got some runs under their belt now, and they still have plenty of batting to come. A fine partnership that between Vessel 76 and Border 43, and the other two did their job at the top as well. The bowling for England, they worked very hard. There was a bit of spin there, there was some movement off the seam, there was some swing, but nothing quite went right for them all day. A wicket to both of them, and one to Phil Edmonds. And I thought Phil Edmonds had a very good day indeed, but not even that can make up for those drop catches. First of all, there was Ian Botham, who put down Vessels. Quite a difficult chance at second slip. He might just have been a fraction slow going for it to his right, but it certainly went very quickly. That was off Les Taylor, who would have had his chance for a first Test match wicket. Then there was Tim Robinson diving away and perhaps misjudging just fractionally the fact that the ball was coming a little slower than he expected. He dived away, and the bowler then was Richard Ellison, who'd been brought on at the City End. And then finally, that Courton bowl of Les Taylor's, who just looked to me to be fractionally slow in going down for it. It came back perhaps a little slower once again than he really thought was going to be the case. So three chances down, and a very, very difficult situation for England.